Infographics is back, answering all the questions other channels are too cowardly to even ask. Today, we're delving into the world of pee. Why does pee smell? And what happens when we mess with Challenge Guy's biology by making him eat different things in a quest to create pee so stinky it melts the toilet bowl? Peeing is a vital process for eliminating waste byproducts from your body and typically comes with a distinct aroma. Some people like that aroma so much they actually wear it like natural perfume. Others insist on using it as a face cleanser, a shampoo, body wash, and even mouthwash. All of these people have embarrassingly successful TikTok channels where you can learn all about the health benefits of using your own pee in the ways nature intended. Every day, man strays further and further from God's light. So while you're drowning in student debt and flipping burgers, someone is raking in millions brushing their teeth with pee and getting strangers to do it too. But enough about the post-cultural urine-flavored dystopia that we've created for ourselves. What's with that smell? Turns out there's a variety of things that can affect the way your pee smells. And yes, we made our challenge guide try every legal way to weaponize that stench. You're welcome. Smelly pee isn't a red flag. Most of the product in your pee is water and waste products filtered by your kidneys. It's accompanied by a slight smell and a yellowish color. Some foods, like beets, can turn your pee a red or a pink tinge. This can be a terrifying discovery or a hilarious prank, assuming you can convince someone to eat a bunch of beets. But your pee can turn red from actual blood as well, with infection or kidney stones being the culprit. However, the accompanying smell, even if it's strong, isn't necessarily a sign of something being wrong with you. If your urine comes out smelling like Puff Daddy's breath, then don't necessarily worry about having to rush to the doctor. There's only a few instances where your personal eau de toilette means you should see a doctor. The first culprit is dehydration. The less water you take in, the more concentrated that waste you expel via urine is going to be. This results in a very strong and unpleasant smell along with dark yellow coloring. You'll likely notice a strong ammonia smell in your pee. That's all the junk your kidneys worked really hard to eject from your body, which is why you shouldn't listen to anyone telling you that pee is some miracle skin serum or the next trendy health drink. And that one is aimed at survival nerds. Stop drinking your own pee. It only dehydrates you faster. You are literally re-ingesting the exact waste your body was trying to push out before. You'll know if you're dehydrated or something funky is going on with you if you also have dry mouth and dry skin. Other obvious signs are feeling thirsty, tired, and a lack of sweat. Severe dehydration can come with dizziness as well. Remaining in a dehydrated state for a long time can cause serious lasting harm to your body. While we're at it, drinking energy drinks or soda is not a good way to stay hydrated. Soda is a diuretic and it'll make you pee more, and energy drinks typically have so much extra crap that it's doing more harm than good. So if you've been chugging Logan Paul and KSI's Prime energy drink without taking in water, you are likely flirting with dehydration. You're probably also full of what scientists call forever chemicals, which Prime has not disclosed and is currently being sued over. The next culprit making your forbidden lemonade extra sour is food. Many foods come packed with compounds that, once broken down, emit a very strong odor. Eating a lot of them at once can concentrate them in your urine, giving it an extremely strong odor on the way out. Asparagus is a notorious culprit, as anyone who is a fan of failed broccoli can attest to. You might be surprised to find that foods like honey and dried fruit can give your next golden shower a sharp stink. Coffee is a notorious culprit as well, and given its popularity, odds are you've had stinky piss syndrome and you don't even know about it. Alcohol, garlic, onion, and Brussels sprouts round out the stinky food list. Although it seems like the type of alcohol can make a difference. For further research, we got your favorite lab rat plastered on various types and had him report his stink. But more on that later. If you're looking to craft a custom piss scent though, vitamins and supplements can engineer a unique brand of pee aroma. B vitamins are water-soluble, and thus your body doesn't store them. Once it's had its fill, anything left over gets flushed through the kidneys. Too much vitamin B1 can give your pee a strong and very fishy smell. It's something to consider if you're getting tired of the same old stink or want to surprise a romantic partner. Remember that surprise and spontaneity are the key to long-term relationships. There's some things a girl shouldn't have to ask for: flowers, an engagement ring, and pee that smells and tastes like fish. Prenatal vitamins and vitamin D can also produce a strong smell, as many pregnant women can vouch for. What happens when a man takes prenatal vitamins, and how does it affect his pee? Don't worry, we'll find out soon enough. If you love the smell of fresh baked bread, good news! Some meds make your pee smell like yeast. Sulfonamides are medicine that contains sulfur and regularly prescribed as antibacterials to treat diabetes and arthritis. If you're taking regular sulfonamides, then you are concentrating the notoriously smelly sulfur in the kidneys for expulsion, giving your urine a very pungent funk. If you've ever used the bathroom after an elderly person, you've likely gotten hit face first with a strong, pungent waft of urine smell. Various health conditions can also result in a strong pee smell. Metabolic diseases, liver or kidney disease, menopause, some STDs like chlamydia, and infection of the prostate or bladder can all produce a distinct and strong aroma. These, however, come with accompanying symptoms, which should have already keyed you in that you need to see a doctor. Probably the most well-known cause of strong urine smell, though, is from diabetes. Because your body is trying to eject as much sugar as possible, it can actually give your pee a sweet or fruity smell. It might be tempting, but remember that Satan's lemonade is still not good for you to drink. One especially weird urine smell comes from maple syrup urine disease. This life-threatening genetic condition causes your body to be unable to break down some amino acids. The result is a buildup of amino acids in your blood, which can become toxic and lead to death. A symptom of this disease is urine, earwax, and even sweat that smells like maple syrup. So if you're running around smelling like a Canadian and have seizures, sleepiness, irritability, and zero appetite, probably time to see the doctor. As it affects children and babies, though, you either already know you have it or you're dead. If it's the latter, we appreciate you coming back from the afterlife to give our video more views. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Trimethylaminuria isn't the name of a forbidden Hogwarts spell. It's the name of another condition that will funk your piss up. This condition occurs when your body can't break down a specific compound called trimethylamine. Much like with the amino acids in maple syrup disease, this results in a buildup of that compound which can get out of control. To top it off, this compound smells like a loaded diaper stuffed with fish guts and left to bake in the sun. This will cause your sweat, breath, and of course your urine to smell like Sauron's butthole. Tyrosinemia is a condition that affects your body's ability to break down the amino acid tyrosine. This results in your urine smelling like boiled cabbage, which is probably a comforting smell for most of you grubby cabbage farming peasants out there. So now you know why urine smells, but how can you concoct a piss aroma so powerful that even Aquaman might mistake you for royalty? For that pressing scientific answer, we turned to our challenge guy. First up, we tried the true and tested method of good old-fashioned dehydration. To pull this off, we banned your favorite lab rat from drinking anything but the bare legal minimum for 24 hours. The infographics medical nerds recommended this to be 15 ounces of water. We would, after all, need something for him to pee out. Cruel? Maybe. Entertaining? Definitely. We'll leave the results to him. Results: strong, pungent odor. Thickly yellow color. Kinda feel like fainting a bit. Would rank smell at 7 out of 10 in stink. Not unfamiliar, used to this from various wilderness survival training scenarios in the past. We gave him a day to reset and moved on to food. Did you know it's possible for a human to survive on nothing but asparagus for 24 hours? Well, we all do now. Asparagus results: horrible smell. Also, I hate asparagus. Strong, pungent, with an almost metallic tang. This is probably the most concentrated asparagus urine that's ever been produced. And it's awful. 9 out of 10 stink. Would not recommend. Up next, we tested alcohol's effect on urine and the limits of Challenge Guy's liver. Over the course of several days, we plied your favorite lab rat with 4 different alcohols on a quest to create the stinkiest of Alaskan leg warmers. Gin. I love gin. I don't know if it's the various things I mixed with it, but pee ended up smelling slightly lemony. Not at all unpleasant. Probably still wouldn't use it to wash my hair or anything stupid like those piss gurus do. And nobody better get any ideas for future challenges along this vein either. Stink clocks in at a 2 out of 10. Would recommend. Vodka. I've never liked beer, but I've been shooting vodka straight since I was 19 and first joined the military. Doesn't mean I like it, but it gets the job done fast and cheap. Urine stink is moderate, a solid 4 out of 10. Maybe slightly stinkier than normal pee. Whiskey. Always hated whiskey. Don't care for it coming out. Also, brutal hangover. Should have done this one in between the two alcohols I actually enjoy. Piss smells like a Hoosier roadie's breath. 6 out of 10 stink factor. Beer. I really should have thought this order through because I've always hated beer. Plus size is it makes you pee a lot, so it didn't take long to deliver the goods. Downside is it tastes like ditch water and makes your pee smell fierce. Strong, almost woodsy aroma, but the wrong type of woodsy. Maybe I should have tried Asian beer instead. Stink factor a solid 7 out of 10. Now legally, We are not able to force our resident lab rat to partake in huge amounts of supplements or take prescription drugs, but we were advised that prenatal supplements would be absolutely fine. However, they required time to build up in his system, so the next result had to wait for a week. Supplement results. I feel strange, like my body is primed to host life. Probably just my mind PMSing with me, given the context. Pee is awful, though, reminds me of talcum powder in a very bad way. Might just have babies on the brain, though. 4 out of 10 in stink factor, definitely stinkier than normal pee, and unpleasant, but not by too much. And there you have it, your very own guide to crafting forbidden lemonade so stinky even cats would mistake it for their territory. Now go check out why you should never hold your pee, or click this other video instead.